were completely helpless when it comes to the instability. Back when the zone was active, we built ways to get where we needed to go. I need you to head back towards Serum. But don't worry, I won't make you jump into Cappy again. When you're feeling up for it, take the route back to Serum. I'll tell you what's next once you're there. The mass hallucination. I can't believe it happened again. I can't believe I missed it. There's a whole lot standing between where we are and the deep zone. Like another wall and the entire mid zone, for starters. It's not as simple as driving there. We can't control the instability any more than we can control the weather. At the height of limb R&D, thousands of us lived and worked here in the zone. So we built limb stabilizers to make certain sectors and roads a little more predictable than others. It was the only way we could operate as a live research compound despite the instability. And yes, the same technology that destabilized the landscape in the first place. Limb technology was always a double-edged sword from the beginning. We're going to put those stabilizers to work and clear you a path. The old observation towers surrounding Sierra Morta have a map of the stabilizers in that sector. Mind swinging by and finding one?
up security protocols all day, only for one disgruntled employee to program in his name for fun and mess it all up. Anyway, the overload code is 4735. Find that stabilizer map and scan it for me.
Oh, boy. I was assigned to clean these towers out every time the guards rotated. And things I saw. Let's just say that keeping watch on Sierra day in and day out did not make for a good time. I didn't envy those guards one bit.
woods there can be a bit of a maze. If you get lost, follow the pipes. The Limtech and those stabilizers ran so damn hot, only more Limtech could contain it from complete meltdown. Francis were going on about, but don't worry, I won't be nearly as long-winded. Because there honestly isn't much that we know about it. It happened on the morning of September 14th, 1961. My colleague, Dr. James Kay, was conducting experiments at a highly classified site in the Deep Zone. He was assisted by my husband, Dr. Alan Turner. At 0400, their experiment unleashed a gamma-ray surge that instantly killed both of them. The surge was an impossible amount of energy, orders of magnitude greater than any man-made source. It also triggered hallucinations in anyone awake within a 10-mile radius. It was a burst of widespread insanity, but only for a short moment.